Sam. It looks like we have a dead counterfeiter on our hands. Simple case of murder. Stabbed. I'll take care of this and have it checked later.
This is a handy little outfit.
Yeah, it's a hand printing press, special inks, and special papers. Yeah. Don't touch anything, Sam. You're liable to get that ink on you, and that's the kind of ink that won't rub off.
Yeah, I notice it's all over the fingers of the corpse.
Mm-hmm. Well, everything seems to be here except the plates for printing of the money. Oh, what's this? A fresh sample. Take a look, Sam.
Say, that's the best job of counterfeiting I've ever seen.
Yeah, that's the kind of case the Treasury Department will be interested in. I'll notify Washington immediately. You better wait here for the coroner, Sam.
Hiya, Fluff. I want to see the mole.
So what? Maybe the mole doesn't want to see you.
Just go and tell him I want to see him, that's all.
Look, the last time you were here, he threw you out of his office. Said you are no good chiseling rat and he wasn't going to advance you any money.
That was last time. Just go in and tell him I've got the Derville plates.
What are you doing, selling dishes?
Will you go in and tell him I got the Derville plates? He'll know what I'm talking about.
Okay, find yourself a seat. If the mole will see you, I'll come and get you.
Who's there?
It's me, Fluff.
Come in.
Why do you keep the lights off all the time?
Because I like the dark. I can relax and I can think.
Well, I can't relax and I can't think. I don't like the dark. Can I turn on the lights?
All right. Put them on if you want them.
Why don't you keep the lights on like everybody else does?
Because I'm not like everybody else. Well, what do you want?
Reg Rolfe is outside. Says he wants to talk to you.
I threw him out the last time he was here. I don't want anything to do with that little chiseler.
That's what I told him.
Well, what are you standing there wasting my time for?
He said he wanted to talk to you about some dishes. I think he called them the Derville plates.
The Derville? The Derville plates? Well, why didn't you tell me? Send him in.
Just what are the Derville plates?
Oh, you're kind of curious, huh? Well, I'll tell you. The Derville plates are engravings. Derville is the finest engraver of counterfeiting plates we've ever had. Well, what are you waiting for? Bring him in.
Derville plates, huh?
Will he see me?
Well, Ralph, you're going to be a man of importance for once in your life. The mole will see you.
Now, he won't be impertinent to me anymore. As a matter of fact, pretty soon I'll be rolling up plenty of money. It's just what a little fluff like you likes.
In your case, money won't help much.
Hello, mole.
All right, what's your story? Come to the point.
Won't shake hands.
Come on, make it snappy. I'll give you three. One, two.
Can we be alone?
Okay. Fluff meeting.
Mind if I light a cigarette?
Yes, I do mind. I don't like the light. The flash hurts my eyes. Come on, I'll give you 1 minute.
I know where the spiked Derville counterfeit plates are.
Yeah?
I said I know where the spiked Derville plates are.
That don't mean a thing unless you got your hands on them.
Of course I can lay my hands on them. In fact, I can get these two hands on plenty of them.
What's the matter? What's the matter with your hands?
Won't come off.
Special printer's ink, huh? Sit down. Or you stay there.
What's that, Mo? What's that?
That's none of your particular business. Where are those plates?
I can lay my hands on them. They're worth $1 million. In fact, nobody has ever passed any money made from them yet.
$1 million? Where does a punk like you expect to get $1,000,000?
$50,000. I'll take 10 grand for them right now.
Listen, you'll take whatever I give you.
Cut it out.
Did you call us, Mo? Yeah. I think I've got a job for you two guys to do. You know, Mo, you got so many tunnels crisscrossing each other down there, I almost got lost. Why don't you put some lights in them? I don't like lights.
If I didn't lead him around like a little baby, he'd get lost down there.
That's the way I want it.
Well, next to you, Mo, I know the tunnels best.
Mo, I'll give you my phone number. When you want me, you can call me.
Listen. Sit down. When I tell you to sit down, sit down. When I tell you to get up, you get up.
Cut out!
Oh. You could put your hands on him when you want it, huh?
Oh. Where's my 10 grand?
Shut up!
It's all right, Mole. If you want him, if you really want him, you can have him. It's okay. It's okay.
You just keep your nose clean, and I'll give you a chance to pass some of this. After I get it printed.
Listen, Mo, I've been thinking this over. You're not giving me a square deal. I want some dough now.
You want some dough now? How much dough do you want, punk?
$10,000. I'll take 5 grand right now.
Listen to that, fella. The punk wants 5 grand. I think you two guys ought to stay here and have a long talk with him. Maybe it'll be more reasonable. I got to go and check on that Daniel. After all, I am in the restaurant business.
We just got the report from the Treasury Department. This man, Spike Durville, who was found dead. It seems they've been looking for him for a long time because he's one of the finest engravers in the country. And now we're working hand in glove with the T-Men on this case.
Running down counterfeiters is their business. Now ours is solving murder.
And that's just what we're going to do.
Stop dropping ashes on my rug.
Oh, I'm sorry, Mo.
What's that squat?
Oh, that's only blood.
Blood?
Yeah.
I told you I never want anything like that to happen in here. Was it absolutely necessary?
Well, it's that chopper. He got excited, and the first thing you know, he croaked rough. I tried to stop him. I know you don't like those sort of things.
Where's the body?
We took it through the tunnel to that deserted house on the next lot.
Take a chair and see if you can cover that spot. No, never mind. Why did he have to shoot Roth in here? Now, look, Martin, that's not a very big rug. Roll it up and get rid of it with the body.
Why, Mo, that's a real good rug.
There's a lot of things you've got to learn if you're going to be successful in this business, Martin.
What's that?
That the police are no fools. You could never prove that those weren't human bloodstains on the floor.
Gee, Mo, you're pretty smart.
Sure I am. Now get rid of that rug and Rolf's body, so nobody will ever find it.
Okay, well.
How about this Reg Roth that was found floating in the bay?
Yeah, Tracy.
All the reports are in, aren't they?
Well, all but the stains on his fingerprints. Gillis is bringing those in.
What does ballistic say about the bullets?
Well, they say that he was killed by a bullet from the gun RG-4938A.
Is there any registration on that gun?
Yeah, it was registered to a man named Willard S. Kahn.
Kahn? Oh, that's our old friend that's in jail. You remember Kahn.
Oh, yeah. That's the fellow that was hurt in that battle with Blowtop.
Yeah. Well, since he's in jail, it's obvious that he couldn't have fired the weapon.
Yeah. And the fingerprint gives us the whole story on Reg Roth. Not a very savory character.
Oh. Those stains on his fingers now. Oh, thanks, Gillis. Let's see.
Well, the laboratory says it was made from special engraving ink. That is, all made from the same lot.
Well, then the ink on Roth's fingers matches the ink on Derville's.
Beyond the shadow of a doubt, there can be no question because the ink was made in such small quantities.
Well, that means that Roth killed Derville.
Right. I'll tell you what I want you to do, Sam. Number one, make up a comprehensive report of this and send it to the Treasury Department. And number two, go downstairs and talk to Kahn about that gun.
That'll be a pleasure.
If it can't be your friend Sam Ketchum. Well, how are you this fine afternoon?
Fine, Murphy, and you?
Same as yours. You're right in the pink.
Oh, Dick Tracy sent me down here to see if I could get some information out of Kahn. Is he in any condition to talk?
Why, sure he can talk. You might as well say he's almost as good as brand new again.
Well, that's good news. You take me down to him?
No sooner said than done. Right this way.
After you, Murphy.
Oh, this Kahn, he's a tough guy. Hey, Kahn. Kahn. There's a man here to see you.
Now, what do you want, copper?
Well, how's my friend Kahn today?
What's it to you?
Hey, now, look, that's no way to be talking to an officer of the law.
I don't have to take any of your lip either.
Imagine that, Doc. Now, here's a man who's a public charge, complaining about the way he's being treated by public servants.
All right, now, Murphy, I have some business with Kahn. You'll excuse us, please.
Certainly. I know when I'm not wanted. You don't have to be so polite, you know.
What's your story?
Well, according to the police records, you own a gun with serial number RG-4938A.
I did own a gun.
You know, you're kind of lucky to be in jail.
What do you mean, lucky?
Well, there was a man killed with a bullet from that gun.
Well, I got a good alibi. I'll shove off.
You know, you're coming up for trial next week.
What about it?
Well, I'm not authorized to bargain for information, but I can tell you this much. You cooperate with the authorities, and I feel sure the district attorney will keep that in mind when he draws up the charges against you.
Sounds interesting. What do you want to know?
About that gun.
What about it?
Who'd you sell it to?
Just between you and me?
Naturally.
I sold it to a guy named Chopper.
Chopper? Never heard of him. What do you know about him?
Not a thing. I met him in a restaurant. He wanted a gun, and I was broke, so I sold him mine.
What's the name of the restaurant?
The Hole in the Wall.
Oh, yes, I know the place. Over on Victor and 9th. Not a very nice place.
I ain't choosy. The food's good.
Yeah. What else you know about this man?
Not a thing.
It's not very much. I guess it'll have to do. Thanks.
All right, fine. Yes, I'll let you know later. Goodbye. Well, Sam, what'd you find out from Kahn?
He says he sold the gun.
To whom?
Some man named Chopper.
Chopper? Chopper, I never heard of him. Get me Gillis. Go on, continue.
Well, I asked him where...
Gillis, this is Tracy. I want you to find out if you have a record on a man named Chopper. That's right. No, I'll hold on. So?
Well, as I was saying, he says he met this guy Chopper in a little restaurant called The Hole in the Wall. It's a place over on Victor and 9th. He asked me if he knew anything more about him, and, well, that's all the information I could get out of him.
Yes, Gillis. What? You have no record of a man named Chopper, or any similar name. All right, thanks. Well, it seems we have a new operator in this territory. We've got to work fast. A man comes into town with a gun, and already he's killed somebody, and we don't know what he looks like.
Oh.
Where are we going, Sam?
Well, I figured you'd want to go over and take a look at that restaurant.
You've been working with me so long, you're already a step ahead of me.
Like they're doing a thriving business.
Yes.
Hello. Can I help you, gentlemen?
Now, we're here on a matter of business.
Well, if you're selling anything, I'll buy it.
Nothing like that ever happens to me.
Oh, Sam.
We're looking for a man named Chopper.
Chopper? Never heard of him.
You mean to say you've never seen a man around here by the name of Chopper or heard the name before?
With a name like that, who could forget?
Well, you won't mind if we stay and have a bite to eat?
Of course not. That's our business. Have a chair.
Thanks.
Hi, Spring.
Hi, Fluff. Well, Mr. Dick Tracy, it's indeed a privilege and pleasure to see you here. Your clientele is improving every day. Yes, indeed. The hole in the wall is drawing a much higher class of people.
Thanks, Brigham.
You'll excuse me? Come down.
What would you gentlemen like?
Well, I'll have a nice, thick piece of homemade apple pie, chocolate ice cream, and a cup of coffee.
Well, you'll have a nice, thin piece of store-bought apple pie with vanilla ice cream. And with it, I'll serve you a cup of mud.
Well, I'll have the same thing then, and with vanilla ice cream.
I told you we didn't have any chocolate. Okay.
Look, Tracy, if we can't locate this guy Chopper here, what do you think we ought to do? After all, we've got no information on him. No pictures, no fingerprints, nothing.
This presents a very difficult problem. We only had some clue, something to go by.
Well,
all we know is the man's name, and nobody ever heard of him.
After I finish my coffee, my pie, my ice cream, I'll be in a better mood to work. Then I'll give you an answer.
Okay. Excuse me just a moment. This message.
Who is it?
Jay Blackstone Springham.
Either you guys need a lawyer?
Not yet.
Well, hello, Shyster. What do you want?
Sir, I resent being called a Shyster. I happen to be the finest criminal lawyer that money can buy.
Yeah, so what? Now, what do you want?
Well, inasmuch as you're a client of mine, I feel it my duty to warn you that Dick Tracy and Sam Catchum are in the dining room having pie a la mode and coffee.
Pie a la mode, no less.
With vanilla ice cream.
What does he want?
Well, quite by accident, of course. I overheard them talking.
What did you hear?
Well, they kept repeating the name Chopper. It seems they're looking for him.
What did you two guys do wrong?
Well, now, if you gentlemen did do wrong, please remember the name, J. Blackstone Springham. As I said before, the finest lawyer that money can buy.
We might use you sometime.
All right, Shyster, what else?
Oh, yes. Excuse me. Yeah. Yes, well, they did say that they have no record of anyone called Chopper. No fingerprints. As a matter of fact, they have nothing, absolutely nothing to go on except the name.
Thanks, Springham. I'll remember you for this.
Was nothing? Nothing really, nothing at all. My pleasure. Gentlemen?
Dick Tracy's down in the restaurant with Sam Catchum.
I know. He's asking about Chopper. What did you tell him?
Told him I never heard the name before.
Well, that's good going, Fluff. What else?
Tracy says he wants to talk to the manager of the restaurant.
What's he doing, complain about the food?
Oh, no, nothing like that. He wants to ask you something about Chopper.
Well, I'll tell you what you do, Fluff. You tell him that I can't see him right away. But you bring him in here in a couple of minutes. I've got a good idea. It's a good idea. You know what, Chopper? I'm going to introduce you to Dick Tracy.
Oh, no, you don't. You're not going to turn me in for this just because you're my boss and pay me every week.
Give me that gun.
Leave me alone, you big gorilla.
Now, listen. I've got an idea for the joke, and you're going to go along with it.
Not if it means seeing Dick Tracy. I ain't going to.
Oh, yes, you are. Sit down.
What's the idea?
Listen, Dick Tracy don't know you. He hasn't got anything on you. And Dick Tracy wants to see the proprietor of this restaurant. So for the next 10 minutes, you're going to be the mole.
I don't want to do it. I don't think it's safe.
You're going to do as I say.
You do as the mole tells you.
Now look, Martin. You see that nothing goes wrong. And if Dick Tracy or Sam start to make a move, get behind them. You've got the gun and know what to do.
You know, Mole, You got a pretty good sense of humor. Yeah, a pretty good sense of humor. I should have played along with a gag all the time.
Now you're learning.
Well, gentlemen, it's about time now. You can go in and see the mole. He's the manager, you know.
I never heard of him either.
Neither did I.
Right this way.
Wish me luck.
Are you the manager of this restaurant?
Yeah.
What's your name?
They call me the Mole, don't they, Martin?
They sure do, Mole.
You're Dick Tracy, aren't you? And you're Sam Ketchum.
That's right.
I've heard of you two great detectives. Read about you in the newspapers all the time. Probably the greatest team that ever was. Never miss a criminal, do you?
Well, we try not to.
You hot on the trail of some big case now?
Well, let's say that we're looking for somebody.
Yeah. What do you know about a guy named Chopper?
I don't know anything about him. What does he look like?
We don't know. We have no description of him. All we have is his name. But we'd like to talk to him about a little matter.
Well, I run a respectable business here. Maybe you could tell me what you want this Chopper for.
He's wanted on suspicion of murder.
Murder? Well, if I ever meet him, I'll let you know. Goodbye. What's wrong?
Yeah. What's wrong?
Nothing, nothing. Well, goodbye. Glad to meet you two men. We'll probably be seeing each other again.
Never can tell.
No, you never can. Well, goodbye. Come on, Sam.
Did you see the way he grabbed my hand?
Yeah. I thought I was going to have to let them both have it. Right in the back, too.
Good thing you were here. He gave me an awfully funny look when he shook my hand.
I didn't like the looks of that big guy, Mountain.
Oh, and he had a gun in his pocket aimed right at our backs.
Yeah. What made the other guy so nervous when you looked at his hand?
Do you remember the ink on Spike Durville's hands and the ink on Red Roth's hands?
Sure.
Well, that came from the Durville plates.
That's right.
And that same ink was on the Mole's hand.
Well, why didn't you nab him?
I couldn't, because Mountain had a gun on us. But I've got an idea.
What's that?
We'll drop in a nearby doorway and keep an eye on this restaurant manager, the Mole, and see what he does.
Yeah, but supposing he don't come out soon.
If he doesn't come out soon, we'll send some squad cars and pick him up. Come on.
Let's go.
Keep an eye on that entrance.
You know that guy we thought was the Mole? You know, he almost got me in that gun battle. Why, the bullet just missed my ear by that much.
Yes, he did come pretty close to us.
Yeah, but we put him in the morgue where he won't bother anybody else.
No, funny thing, when we went through the Mole's papers, his name wasn't the Mole at all.
No, it was Chopper, the fellow we were looking for in the first place.
Now we've got to find the Mole.
Yeah. You know, Tracy, it was a fine piece of deduction. Tracing the ink from Spike Durville to Red Roth proved that Roth killed Durville. Then ballistics pinned the murder of Roth on Chopper. And you found Chopper because he had the same kind of ink on his hands, which proved that he was implicated. Yes, sir, Tracy. You did a real good job.
Well, thanks, Sam. Thanks a lot.